many more people that are sick right now that
can't
go on the waiting list because of the strict guidelines. You know, he can tell you that himself because of what we had to go through to get on the waiting list. But I've seen a lot of people that couldn't meet the requirements of a very strict waiting list, and they could have possibly be on that waiting list and have their life saved too. So with the availability of more organs, no missed opportunities, lives are more live, and isn't that what life's about?
Yeah.
You know, so what we want to do first is bring this to the public to see how they feel. Put out a referendum and let people say yes or no, you know. And then I'm very confident that they'll say yes. And once it says yes, then we can get the ball rolling to get the system in place, you know. And then with that, we would urge Alan Rock to create more hospitals, because there isn't enough hospitals. If there's going to be an increase in transplantations, we don't have enough centers across Canada right now. There's too many remote places where it makes it quite difficult to retrieve organs. So we would have to logistically look at you know, taking care of all that. And with the right spirit and desire and planning, you can take care of everything, you know. And this is what our priorities in our country should be, you know, to making sure that we can save every available life that we can, and we're doing everything that we can. So our message from community to community is talking about the system also. To have the best system possible in our country. Not, you know, the best. We want the best, you know. So
yeah, there's no substitute for that.
No substitute. So we think that one that will offer no missed opportunities is the best system.
Right.
And not only that, there's a great benefit to the donor family. Jean Camille is processing a lot of grief right now, but there's also comfort.
Oh, yeah.
Knowing that lives were saved from a very tragic situation.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of comfort throughout the grieving process, and also knowing that maybe one day they could meet possibly the recipients and have a sense of carrying Yannick's memory on, you know, more than just memory, you know. So there's lots of benefits here that can't be ignored, you know. And, I'm meeting with Mr. Rock in a couple of months.
Oh, yes?
Yeah. He knows everything I'm doing. He knows what the agenda is and what's wrong with you.
He's a tough guy.
He's a tough guy, but he's got a heart too. You know.
We need one.
So, yeah. But you know, we're gonna show our report because I have a lot of support behind me on this
right.
So far. Police chiefs right across Canada,
mm-hmm.
Lots of municipal support, you know.
Yeah.
We have some MPs, so we're going to show them how the voice of Canadians.
It shouldn't be too difficult to process a program.
Very simple, very simple. Yeah, very, very simple. And we're just a couple of steps away from being able to save so many lives.
To jump from the driver's license to a safe system.
You don't know how many times people have come up to me and said, I don't even know if it's on my driver's license. Where do I sign? You know?
Mm-hmm.
On the pew meeting.
No. See, you're another one. You're 70% of the province.
Yeah.
I'm telling you right now, 70% of the province do not know that.
Non, c'est maintenant, on l'a plus en arrière de nos licences.
I didn't check that.
Non, on les a plus.
Not because of negligence.
No, because it wasn't brought to your attention.
Because of my age.
Yeah. But see, that's another misconception.
Yeah.
Great-great-grandmother, 91 years old, had five good working organs, five people were saved. Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes.
Oh, well. Check my
So, you know, we have to clear all these misconceptions too, you know, and all the...
Yeah.
So, you know, that will be the best way, you know, to because there's so much suffering that goes on when you're on the waiting list. You're feeling very desperate. It feels like you're trying to win a jackpot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, mm-hmm. It shouldn't be that way. You know, you should be able to go on that waiting list very optimistically. You know, because when you're on that waiting list, you meet a lot of people, and you see the people that don't receive it, and then you, am I next?
Oh, yeah.
You know, so
very stressful.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, a few steps we could change on that.
Well, I hope so.
I'm gonna keep banging the drum hard.
That's great. That's great.
You said that when you were walking that you just have 2 days left.
Yes, and he probably has a similar story. I don't know what his story, but. Yeah, because sometimes it goes right down to the wire, right down to, you know, I was rushed to the hospital, I had complete liver failure, and doctor said, you know, hope you made all your final arrangements, because you only have a couple of days left, you know, and I knew that day was coming, you know, because you prepare a little bit for it. But that's how close it got. I did hit a jackpot. I was very fortunate, you know. So.
Mm-hmm. When I got my graft 10 years ago, there were 450 people in front of me waiting.
Mm-hmm.
And I had 3 months. I was dying in 3 months. I didn't have very long to live, only 3 months to live. The last 4 days, 5 days, I got my heart and lungs that time. Mm-hmm. Anyway, we'll dire en français. Moi, j'étais au Jewish hospital. J'avais super accueil pour moi. Il m'a donné 3 mois à vivre. Les dernières minutes, les dernières heures, j'ai eu mon cœur pour moi. Oui, le cœur.
C'est comme qu'ils appellent tout le kit.
Tout le kit.
C'est comme ça qu'ils appellent le sport.
J'ai été donneur. Je n'ai pas signé. I didn't sign my organ. And the doctor telephoned up to me and he asked me, what do you want to do with your heart? Mm-hmm. If you can save somebody, save them. I gave it my heart and I got a heart and lungs. The guy from Quebec.
How do you know him?
Huh?
You see him?
Oui. I saw him, but not him, his family. And I went where he was buried. I know where he's buried in Montreal, Quebec.
Yeah.
He's okay?
He ain't okay. The guy that got my heart, yes.
Okay.
And the guy that's dead for me, I know the family too.
Okay.
That's hard too. When you go into his, just in front of him, he's dead. There's something that passed in, inside of me that maybe you sort of will feel the same thing. Mm-hmm. Between me and you, we know what we can, we feel.
I think when I went to visit the Pope, the Pope called it a genuine act of love when someone makes the a genuine act of love.
I was j'étais plus content de donner que recevoir. Je savais donner la vie à un autre.
Vous aviez tellement
entendu. Oui. I was so glad to give. I wasn't glad to have. I was glad to have it, not like what I was glad to give. It's a gift. It's a gift from God, and He gave me a gift.